suddenly, his name was a household word.
Yeah, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another DVD / Blu-ray update. This is going to be my haul for May of 2015, everything I picked up in May. And I will forewarn you, I have no idea how long this video is going to last, but it's going to be a long one. I have a lot of stuff. I picked up a lot of stuff. I had some stuff sent to me from friends. I'm just going to rotate this table here so it's a little easier for me. From some companies too, which was kind of cool too, but most of the stuff I did buy myself. Yeah, fucking, you know, companies like Screen Factory this month just burnt a goddamn hole in my pocket as usual. But first off, Chars to everybody out there. Grab a beer, sit back, and enjoy the motherfucking update. Yeah. Alrighty, so first off here, I want to show something I picked up. I posted a picture on Instagram of this right after I grabbed it. We had a fan con here in the city I live in, and Tia Carrera was going to be there. And oddly enough, this was actually kind of strange. So I brought this DVD up to get signed, and she looked at it and she goes, "Holy shit." She's like, "That movie has a DVD release?" She didn't even know this had a DVD release. And then she continued to tell me that I was the first person that she'd ever signed something like this, obviously, because she didn't even know it had a DVD release, which I feel kind of honored that I'm, like, the only person, because I'm pretty sure nobody else in the city has this release. And that is Zombie Nightmare. I didn't buy this recently, of course, but I got it signed by Tia Carrera. This was her first feature film, of course, before, you know, she made it huge with Wayne's World and stuff, but yeah, you know, everybody in line had Wayne's World stuff, and I was like, oh, come on. But yeah, if you can see that, it says Moods, XOXO. I have to say, man, Tia Carrera was very, very nice, and she's still beautiful as hell. Looks awesome, and she was really nice to talk to, man. She gave me the time, and we talked about the film, and she's like, it's such a shitty movie, I can't believe you like it. I laughed so hard when she said that. She's like, that movie's terrible. But I'm like, you know what? Yeah, it is. It's a bad movie, but it's fun. And she's like, yeah, you're right. But cool stuff right there. I was happy to get that signed up. But okay, moving along into the DVDs and all the other... You can kind of see the stack in the corner there. First up here from Mondo Macabro. Yeah, I picked up about 4 releases this month, and they all came in red cases. I'm very proud about that. I've had bad luck with Mondo releases. Being sealed in black cases, strange. First up here is Gravida. So it's an Alain Rollet-Gelee film. I love his films, man. Redemption, the Kino line, released a bunch of films by him that I was very impressed with. So I've been dying to check this one out, but I love Mondo Macabro. Definitely wanted to grab that one. Next up here is a Italian film called The Snake God. My boy Zach was, you know, he was, I think we were Skyping one night. We were drinking and shit, and I was drinking, he was smoking, and he started laughing. He's like, we started talking about The Snake God, and I just ordered it, and I'm like, yeah, I just ordered it, and he starts laughing. He's like, fuck me, you got a problem. But yeah, I've heard good things, so thank you, Zach, for recommending me that one. And seriously, I'm dropping fucking DVDs. This one right here was actually the other one that I ordered when I was talking to Zach on Skype one night, and this is... Girl Slays of Morgana Le Fay, right there. So yeah, looking forward to checking this one out. This one looks really fucking cool. Another French film from the early 70s, 1971. Love me some Mondo Macabros. Like I said, man, stoked they're all in red cases for once. Fucking awesome. All still sealed. Need to check them out. Artsploitation was kindly enough to send me over this release, which hasn't been released yet. But be on the lookout for review, because I'm going to be reviewing this, and I've heard really good things about it so far, which is has me ecstatic about it. And that is The House with 100 Eyes. This looks really, really fucking awesome. It's basically, from what I've read on the back and what I've heard, it's kind of about like snuff filmmaking and stuff, so kind of found footage style, but I heard it's really good. Looking forward to checking that one out right there. Anchor Bay was kindly enough to send over this one to me, and I did a review, and I wasn't too sure on this one, because some of these films could be kind of generic, and this one turned out to be fucking fantastic, and it's Avenged. awesome, awesome revenge flick. It's basically a rape revenge flick with a twist, kind of. But I really like the story, man. I like the characters. She plays a, she's a deaf mute, tries to save like a Native American from being these rednecks. They're hunting these guys down and basically killing them. Of course, it doesn't go so well. They capture her, end up raping her and doing some nasty things. She ends up dying, and local shaman kind of resurrects her, and unfortunately also brings upon an Apache warrior's soul or something like that into her body, and then they go on a killing rampage. It's actually, you know, as lame as that kind of sounds, it's really fucking good. It was gory, it was fun, it was well executed. I had a lot of fun with this. Check out Avenged. I did a full review for this, so I guess I didn't really need to explain the whole fucking thing again because I'm retarded. Yeah, next up here from Anchor Bay. This one right here, I was going to do a review for. I'm going to not do one because it's going to be really, really bad. And that is The Vatican Exorcisms. Basically, this is kind of like a found footage film. Not really a found footage. It's like a, you know, it's supposed to be a documentary where this American, which is played by this Italian guy, which is so strange. Actually, the director of the film, Joe Morano, actually stars in this. And he basically goes to the to Italy to investigate the Vatican and all these conspiracy theories and all these things that have apparently happened there and stuff with all these exorcisms and these wild, crazy orgies and all these other things. It has some really good ideas in the beginning, but it's kind of like false advertising a little bit. They present you with all these great ideas in the beginning of the film, and it's basically just him going around witnessing and filming these exorcisms. Something happens to him, and, you know, and it turns out to be a very cliched film. Not good. This was actually really fucking horrible, so don't check it out. Sorry. Next up here, I had to pick this up. Of course, in fucking Canada, I can't find the Blu-ray of this because I swear to God, we did not get any Blu-rays in our fucking Best Buys. I know they were Best Buy exclusives, so we should have. So I grabbed the DVD and it was only like $9, and that is Zombievers. Shit, man. I had a lot of fucking fun with this. Really stupid, this kind of film, man. It's very reminiscent of the 80s. It reminded me of Return of the Living Dead Part 2, where the canister falls out of the truck and then pollutes some waters. And of course, these beavers turn into zombies. And when they fucking bite humans, they actually turn kind of beaverish too. Tons of beaver jokes. Super fucking funny. Practical effects, though, that was really what sold it for me. A couple of the characters were kind of annoying, but, you know, I had a lot of fun with this. I'd actually watch this again with some beers. Pretty good stuff. Next up from Severin here. I finally fucking pulled the trigger on this. This movie never seems to go down in price. Ever. And it is another rape revenge film. You know, me with my rape revenge films, I think I have a problem because I watch too many of them. And that's Last House on the Beach. Of course, it's called Last House something, right? This one is basically about these bank robbers. They're obviously fleeing the scene of the crime. They go out to the country, and where she plays a nun, and she's got some students out there, and they're doing some training and stuff like that. They're studying for exams, and of course, some shit goes down once they, you know, fucking basically home invade this house. You know, it's not bad. It's not bad. It was okay. I really like this actress here. What's her name? Stefana? Or no. That's not her name. Shit. She's the girl that plays in Flava the Heretic. She's in that one too. She's pretty good looking actually. But it was okay. It was okay. I had fun with it. Next up here is Livid. Now here's a copy. If you guys watched my update from last time, I picked up a copy of Livid, and of course it was the French edition that didn't even have English subtitles. I was so pissed. So I had to reorder this, and yeah, so this one has English subtitles, so I'm stoked to check it out. Just haven't gotten around to it. Heard nothing but good things. Full Moon, right here. Full Moon's been pretty hit and miss with me lately. This was super cheap. I couldn't pass it up, especially for the name alone, and that's PMS Cop. I thought this movie started out really good and then just kind of declined big time after the fact. I don't know, man. There was a lot of story, a lot of things going on and stuff, but I think that they kind of fell away from where it was, should have went. I don't know, man. Full Moon is just not on point these days, man, with their films. But this one had a lot of promise, though. But it was okay. You know, definitely, I don't fully recommend it, but I do kind of recommend it at the same time. Just give it a watch. You might like it. Next up is one I actually picked up today in my running arounds and stuff like that. This is a film by Ryan Gosling. You know, that sexy Ryan Gosling. I'm actually a really big fan of Drive and God Only Forgives. So this is his directorial debut, and I was really curious to check it out because I heard it's kind of visually like those films. And, you know, it kind of sounds like those films, the soundtrack and stuff. And that just had me intrigued because I really, really enjoy both those movies. And that is Lost River. Now, unfortunately, in Canada, we don't have a Blu-ray release of this. We have to import this. So I was like, I kind of waited it out. I was going to import it from the US, but I was like, fuck it. I'll just grab the DVD. It was super cheap. It was like 10 bucks. So I'll grab it and check it out. And if I love it enough, then maybe I'll wait for the Blu-ray or whatever. Because this is one of those films that you kind of want to have on Blu-ray because it's very visual. But apparently, so. Lost River, not a horror film, I don't think. I heard it's really weird and kind of trippy, so whatever. Next up is a film here that I've wanted to check out for a while. I heard it's really fucking good, and that's Cold in July. I also grabbed this one today. Cold in July. Heard good things. I can't wait to check it out. Here's a film right here that I really wish I had I probably still should do a review on it. I absolutely love this movie. Fantastic. From, who released this? I'm not even sure. Monster Pictures actually released this out of the UK, and that's Chocolate Strawberry Vanilla. Very, very fucking cool film. Thought it was fantastic about this guy. He's obviously, you know, owns his own ice cream truck, and he's kind of a lonely guy and doesn't really have much friends, and he's very awkward and strange, and he's kind of, the odd thing about him is that he's obsessed with this local kind of TV crime show, and especially this one girl that's on the show. And anyways, one day, he doesn't find out where they're filming in Australia, but he's just parked where they're, you know, where they're filming one day. Anyway, she comes up to the ice cream truck, grabs some ice cream, and he just becomes obsessed with her. Very, very cool fucking film. Definitely give it a shot. I loved it. It was just fantastic. Kind of psychological, very interesting character study about this guy. And yeah, it was just very enjoyable. Loved it. These next two were actually sent to me from my homie Turi, from our podcast page, the 22 Shots of Moods and Horror podcast page on Facebook. He just asked me one day, he's like, do you have these titles? And I said, no. And they just showed up at my door one day. So that's pretty damn cool. And this one is Across the River. And I did watch this. I thought this movie was very, very atmospheric and very intriguing. It's very melodic and kind of ominous. I really enjoyed this. I know a lot of people have mixed opinions on this, but I thought it was actually really creepy and trippy. I don't know, man. I thought it was really cool. I don't want to get in the whole story about it, but very cool film. Just not a lot of dialogue because it's basically just one guy in the film. It's really trippy. And then the other one that he sent me here is Treehouse. Now, I heard a lot of people say the same thing, that they didn't enjoy the ending to this film. Now, I can understand completely why people didn't understand, or not understand, but didn't like the ending in this one. For me, I had no problem with it. I really enjoyed this film. I understand that it seems like it's kind of a cop-out and whatnot, whatever. But I had a lot of fun with this. I actually thought it was pretty damn good. So, not fantastic. It totally sets it up for one thing and then it delivers another thing, which I understand, but I enjoyed Treehouse, man. I thought it was actually pretty well done. Next up here is another UK release. I picked up a lot of films from the UK this month. For some odd reason, we don't have a Region 1 release of this. I don't think we do. And that is the film from 1968 called Twisted Nerve. Now, if you've seen Kill Bill before, this is where that fucking theme whistle comes from, is Twisted Nerve. Yeah, that shit comes from this film right here, from 1968. We just recently did a top 10 films from 1968 episode on 22 Shots of Moods and Horror, and this one just really kind of blew my socks off. I really love this one. Don't want to get into it. Definitely check out the podcast. We go into it a lot more. Me and JP both had this on our top 10 list. Awesome fucking movie, man. Definitely give it a shot. Twisted Nerve. Next up is the latest Dustin Mills film called Apple Cards. This one right here is basically kind of a throwback to the silent era, and a lot of different things that are going on in this one. I'm not going to lie. I think this is the first Dustin Mills film I didn't really care for. I understood completely what he was trying to do. It's very experimental. But I just found a lot of the scenes to drag quite a bit in this one. I don't know. It just really didn't do a lot for me, to be honest. And it only runs about an hour long, and it felt way longer to me. I don't know. It just wasn't my favorite thing in the world. It's okay. Some people I know really enjoyed it, but it's definitely not for everybody. Next up is a 6-movie pack called Serial Psychos. Now, I grabbed this specifically because I wanted it for Blood Massacre, the Don Doler film from 1987 or something like that. I don't know what year it is. 1987. It's the only way you can get the film for some weird reason. And I love Don Doler, man. Of course, Night Beast and shit like that. Really good stuff. Awesome flick, man. It's the only one I've checked out on here so far. It also comes with 13 hip-hop locos. Hip-hop locos. Las Vegas Bloodbath, I Hate You, and Slasher. So, who knows? I'm sure the rest of the films are shitty, but whatever. Serial Psychos, 6-pack. It actually comes on 2 discs, 3 films, and this thing was only about, I think I paid $8 for this or something. I don't know. It's probably worth it. Next up here is a Paul Naschy film that I heard isn't that great, but, you know, I had to pick it up. It dropped down to like $10 on Amazon there for a little bit, and that is the Unliving. So, yeah, I'll give it a shot. It's still sealed, so whatever. Next up is the first Blue Underground DVD I've bought in a long time, because I'm really only missing like a couple out of the entire Blue Underground DVD catalog. I had never upgraded a lot of Blu-rays, but this is one I was missing, and I've been kind of digging these Emmanuel films, and that's Emmanuel in America. So pretty stoked about grabbing this one right here. This is the unrated version, so pretty damn cool, completely uncut. Looking forward to checking this out. Still haven't checked it out, so yeah, Emmanuel in America. These next films right here were sent to me from Midnight Releasing for review. I've always been a big fan of Midnight. I know a lot of people have their issues with Midnight Releasing and Brain Damage films, because, you know, the films can be kind of hit and miss, but, you know, to be honest, they're really picking up their game as, you know, these new days, or, you know, as of now, they've been picking up some new ones. Some new good films. So, anyways, first up here is Bleeding Hearts. I recently reviewed this one, so I'm not going to get too much into it, but I thought this was actually a pretty solid film by Dylan Bank. Really cool cast in it. Pretty interesting premise. Full review on my channel. Go check it out. Next up here is Scavenger Killers, also from Dylan Bank. Pretty much having the same cast as Bleeding Hearts. This one was a lot of fucking fun. Basically kind of a Bonnie and Clyde type story. Really fun, kind of sexually motivated, and I had a lot of fun with Scavenger Killers. Really cool stuff. Hellfire, another film I did a review for. You can find on my channel. Actually, Scavenger Killers is on Body Bags. You can find the review on Body Bags for this. And Hellfire, did a review for this one. This was fantastic. Really fucking awesome flick. Check out the review. Axe to the Grind, another film I did a review for. This one was above average. It was above average with Debbie Rochon. You know, you can check out the full review of it, but I don't think it's her strongest film, but it was still decent. It's worth a watch. Next up here is Crazy Murder. I just did a review of this yesterday. I'm not sure if you guys have checked it out yet, but definitely give it a shot. Holy fuck, this is probably one of the sickest and most deprived films I've watched in so long, man. This was nasty. Really, really fucking nasty. But cool though, man. I really enjoyed it. Not for everybody, but give it a shot though. Next up here is the Bible Belt Slasher. I will be doing a review of this one soon, once I get a little more free time, but the review will be coming out. I know the guy that directed this film, I can't remember what his name is. I know he's this blonde guy right here. Bradley Carenzo. I remember him from the VHS documentary. He was on there. He's the guy that has the VHS, basically movie store in his basement. Pretty fucking cool stuff. But yeah, so that'll be coming. And another one from Midnight here is a film called Misogynist. Now, I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to be doing a review of this one, because I don't really think it's a horror film, but, you know, if I end up really liking it or something, I'll probably do one, but Misogynist, pretty cool stuff. All right, so now into the kind of where did I pick these up from? Second Spin and some charity shop stuff. First up here is Chaos. Been wanting to see this one for fucking ever, man. Really, been wanting to see this forever. And I finally watched it last night, and it's basically Last House on the Left with a different ending. That's pretty much what it is. Pretty fucking nasty, though. Pretty nasty. Not really too sure on how I feel. I kind of liked it, but I don't know. It's not for everybody. Pretty extreme stuff. Next up here is Alien Raiders. Couldn't resist it, man. It was a couple bucks. Sounded fucking cheesy. This one I could not pass up. This is an Olive release on DVD. And it's called Shame the Devil. Yeah, I couldn't pass this one up, man. It was only about $4 or something. So I was like, whatever, $3-$4. So yeah, give it a shot. Now this one right here, I can knock off my wish list. I've had this one on a fucking list to grab for so long. This edition, Your Shot Collection, released by Image. And that is Cave of the Living Dead. This one I've been after for so long. I'm just going to move these DVDs over here because there's too much shit going on here. Yeah, this one's been on a list for ever, so finally knocked that one off the list. Next up here is another Don Doler film. I gotta get my hands on the first one, and that's Alien Factor 2. Some really cheesy stuff released by Retro Media, which is pretty fucking cool, man, that they release this. I gotta get these stickers off here. But I love me some Don Doler, you know, awesome stuff. Next up is a Wes Craven film. I think Wes Craven presents this. Yeah, he presents this film. They actually sent me the wrong edition, though, because I ordered the unrated version. This is the PG-13 version and of They. I have seen this movie. I watched it when it came out, and I can't remember it for the life of me. So I wanted to check it out again. I can't remember if I liked it or not, so I'll give it a shot again once I get the right edition. This one right here, I only grabbed because I have no idea why I grabbed this movie. You know, when I first opened up my box, I was like, did I even order this? And I did. So, and that is Hellbenders. I think I must have read the synopsis on this one. I think it's it's like an exorcist type, demon type film. I don't know. So, I don't know. Give that one a shot. Now, this one I've actually had on a list to grab for a long time, too. It's released by Retro Media also. 25th anniversary edition of Alien Dead. of course I would grab some bullshit like this. Alien Dead, I don't know. This one actually looks pretty damn cool. Might do a review of it. I had to grab this because it just, I love Tiffany Amber Thiessen, man. I think she's fucking so hot, man. Whatever. And that is Shriek If You Know What I Did Last Friday the 13th. I've actually never seen this spoof film before. It's probably fucking terrible. Man, this shit has Coolio in it. It's got Coolio. Yeah. That's pretty awesome, but cool stuff. Finally got my hands on this shit right here. I've been after this one for a long time, and that's Stuart Gordon's Deathbed. It also comes with Castle Freak. I have Castle Freak on DVD and I believe Blu-ray too, so not a big deal now. But I grabbed it for Deathbed, so very, very cool stuff. And these ones right here were like pawn shop pickups. They're only a couple bucks. Yeah, I only grabbed them because they were just sitting there. And whatever. First up is The Mailman. This movie right here was absolutely atrocious. I did watch this. It was fucking terrible. I absolutely hated this movie, so don't check it out. Finally grabbed a copy of this. I never owned this. The Descent 2. I haven't really heard a lot of people talk about this one, to be honest. Strangely and oddly enough, considering the first one, a lot of people consider to be one of the best horror films of the 2000s. But I don't know, I've heard this one isn't as good, but I am curious to check it out, so The Descent 2. I grabbed this one right here, Intermedio, because Edward Furlong was in. I actually like Edward Furlong, I think he's kind of cool, but it's the only reason why I grabbed it. It was $2, so why not? Give it a shot. Next up here is another cheesy-ass pickup called The Chair. I'm just grabbing shit for the sake of grabbing shit, apparently, man. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with my life anymore. Candy Strippers, not Candy Stripers, not the porno, Candy st- strippers. Candy stripers. Candy strippers. Yeah, this one looks awful. The Graveyard, another one that looks really, really fucking bad. I don't know what is with all these Lionsgate films, but they seem to produce a lot of bullshit. I did not pay $9.99 for this, but this is Burning Night, and I've actually heard decent things about this, so willing to give this one a shot right here. Next up here is Glass Trap. Now, I had to grab this one because it's a fucking PG-13 insect, killer insect film directed by Fred Olen Ray. Starring C. Thomas Howell. I mean, this was like a no-brainer. Of course I was going to grab that bullshit. Next up here is House of Fallen. Yeah, I don't know. Another film with C. Thomas Howell. What the fuck? Grab Devil. Never seen this one before. $2, why not? I was like, eh, fuck, whatever. And I grabbed this one because I'm a completist and I don't even like the first two films. I Always Know What You Did Last Summer. I'm not a big fan of I Know What You Did Last Summer and the second one. I really do not like those films at all. I think they suck. But yeah, here's the third one. I've actually never seen it. The Ferryman. So I got The Mailman, The Ferryman, The Chair, The Graveyard. Jesus Christ, these are all terrible. And we got a film I grabbed because it is starring Marissa Tomei and I find that she's so fucking beautiful. I absolutely love her. And that is Danica. And I think it's like a more of like a psychological thriller with horror elements and stuff. But, you know, you can't pass up anything with Marissa Tomei that's in that realm of almost horror, I guess. But yeah, that's the way I roll. So, yeah. Fucking beer time, man. Yeah. My Asian part of my update. Aw, yeah. Well, let's get into the Asian portion of the update. Gia. I grabbed a fucking shit ton of Asian films. Now I'm pissed off because I ordered the Ebola Syndrome and it didn't come in for this update. And it would have made a perfect entry into this huge stack of Asian films. I'm on this Asian kick right now. I should probably start watching some of these films, but I'm busy with all these fucking reviews, but... But yeah, let's get into this. First up, I'm going to show a Blu-ray out of order because it is kind of fits into the Asian portion of the update here. And that is Gunwoman, released by Scream Factory. This movie right here, in my opinion, is a modern day classic. 10 out of 10 for me, man. I love this movie so much. It was just fucking fantastic. Great revenge film. Love the story. Love the action. I love the way it was shot. Just an amazing, amazing film. Highly, highly recommend Gunwoman if you've never seen this. Of course, it does come with reversible art. So you'll probably see this if you're hunting for it in stores or whatever. You'll see that cover art if you can see that. But yeah, I highly recommend Gunwoman. Just got to check it out. It's really fucking amazing. Good stuff right there. Gunwoman. Next up is a Shaw Brothers film that's been recommended to me by a bunch of people, actually. And I really dig these films, man. And that's The Boxer's Omen. The Boxer's Omen. So, looking forward to checking that shit out right there. Released by Image. Yeah. Sounds really fucking cool. Next up here from Synapse Films. One of my favorite companies out. If not my favorite company. And that is Battle Girl, The Living Dead in Tokyo Bay. Got this one for about $3 or $4 or something. I don't know. Really good shape. Just super stoked to check it out, man. Yeah. Another Snaps release. I've been after forever this one too, man. And that's Madame O. Another Snaps release. I actually got a bunch more Snaps coming. Yeah, courtesy of my boy Jeremy. But yeah, looking forward to checking that one out right there. Here's the other Mondo Macabro title that I was talking about earlier. And that's Sins of Sister Lucia. This is a Japanese flick. Of course, it came in the red case, which I'm super stoked about. So, like I said, 4 for $4 this month. But yeah, awesome stuff. Love my Nunsploitation. I'm going to have a Nunsploitation theme week probably soon. Next up is one called Black Kiss. This is released by Tokyo Shock. Heard really good things about this one. And when I opened up this one, it was very interesting. I was like, okay, there's the disc. That's pretty cool. But look on the side there. It's got one of those little mini haftas. I can't remember what these things are fucking called. I've never seen one of these in a Tokyo Shock or any Media Blasters releases before. But it is a DVD. And it's like a trailer compilation for like Flesh of the Beast and a few other films and stuff. So that's an interesting touch that they had in here, but never seen one like that. You know, it's the first one, and I own a lot of these. You know, it's very strange it was in this one, but Black Kiss. Next up is one I can't really pronounce too well, and that's Mariner. It's a doll horror movie. It tells you right on the cover, it's a doll horror movie. I love that. But yeah, this one just looked creepy as shit. Released by Elite. Of course, I grabbed this one used too. I got it for a couple bucks. And it doesn't even look like the disc has ever played. It's really strange. But yeah, that one looks creepy as fuck. Next up here is a... what's his name again? Cyan Sano. Strange Circus. Yeah, this guy is a really, really good director, man. He seems to be on point with all his films, but heard nothing but good things about this one, so Strange Circus. Next up, the next bunch of films are Tartan Asian Extreme films. First up here is Sorum. Actually still sealed. I bought this one used, as you can see, but it's still factory sealed, so that was really cool. I got this one for about $3-4, I think. Not even, maybe $3. It might even been $2, I don't know. But that was pretty cool. Got this one brand new, actually, and that's Morbido. You know, of course, with these, I like these slipcovers. But yeah, grab that one. Heard really good things about this one. Been recommended to me, actually, by a bunch of people. You need to check that one out. Next up here is The Red Shoes. Another one that I've heard pretty damn good things about. I can't remember if I've heard anything good about this one or not, but, you know, it's Asian. It was part of the Asian, Tartan Asian Extreme line, so I was like, whatever. Here's the phone. You can find this one for super cheap. You can find most of these for really cheap, actually. Next up is, Memento Mori. I don't know. And they got Maribato. I don't know. These ones have similar titles, but, I believe this is the second or third film in this trilogy. I can't remember how this works. But yeah, there's this one. I heard good things about it. And then we got Wishing Stairs. This one looks really damn fucking cool too. And we got Whispering Corridors, which is the film that started the Asian horror boom. The first in the Whispering Corridors trilogy. And I believe these are the three in the trilogy. I believe so. I believe there's actually like five films connected to this also. And I think I might even have the other ones too. I'm just not 100% sure. I'll have to kind of look that up. Somebody correct me down in the comments, because I never know what I'm talking about ever. No, this is all new. I haven't seen the films yet, so I haven't done much research. But I'm positive this is a trilogy, and apparently there's like a couple other ones. So, but yeah, that's really cool. Next up is a film that I've tried to get a couple times. He kept sending me the wrong copies, and that's Silk. Another Tartan Asian Extreme film. I don't know anything about that one. I've never heard anyone talk about it. This one has been recommended to me by lots of people, actually. My man Tom Horsball has recommended to me. So many people have recommended to me this film. And I finally got around to grabbing it. I got this for super cheap. I only paid about $3-4 for it or something. And that's Mobius. I think that's how you pronounce it, Mobius. Yeah, this one looks really crazy. I've heard really good things, so super stoked about that. Here's another one that's been recommended to me over and over and over again, and I've seen on lots of people's lists, and that's Infection. Yeah, really cool stuff right there. Looking forward to checking that out. Like I said, I haven't even checked out one of these fucking movies yet. Oh, except for Gunwoman. Next up here from Unearthed Films is Red Room. Still sealed. I grabbed this off Amazon for... It was actually kind of expensive. It was like $12 or $13. I was like, ugh, I don't know. But, you know, up here, that's a good deal for Unearthed Films. They usually go for $20, $22. So, grab that one. And, of course, I grabbed the sequel, Red Room 2. Same price. Still, these are still sealed. I just haven't... Actually, this one is not sealed for whatever... Oh, yeah, that's right. The plastic was already coming off in the package. So, yeah. But it's still brand new. And last up for the Asian stuff, which I grabbed, shit man, close to 20 fucking Asian films, and that's Nezila, the Rat Monster. shit, I've been after this for a long time. My boy, You and Your Horror Movies, Matt from You and Your Horror Movies, actually reminded me about this. He had this on a Top 10 Tuesday list, and I was like, oh, fuck, I had this on the list to grab, so I ordered it. I paused the video, ordered it up. Thank you, Matt, for checking, or for, you know, recommending to me without even knowing. But yeah, I've heard really good things about this, so. But yeah, that is, that's the fucking Asian score for the month, minus the Ebola syndrome that didn't come. And actually, now when I think about it, I think there's three films that didn't show up out of my Asian order. So yeah, that was actually not a bad haul right there for, you know, Asian horror films. My Asian film, horror film collection is really getting huge. Yeah, fucking beer time, man, and we're gonna get right into these Blu-rays, and I've got probably 30, so stay tuned for that. Yeah! Alright, it's gonna be fucking Blu-ray time up in this motherfucker, but first, we need another beer because, you know, this update has been going way too damn long. And it's so funny, I'm drinking this Superstore PC Pilsner. I think you can get about 800 or 900 beers for about $20. It's a pretty good deal, man. You gotta, you know, being fucking cheap, I spent all my money on movies, so I can't afford real beer, apparently. No, I just actually don't mind it. It's not bad. Blu-ray time. First up here is one from Synapse Films. And yeah, I had to upgrade this. I mean, Synapse is, they do a pretty good job of, like, not, you know, putting out stuff on Blu-ray that they've, you know, put out on DVD before. But I had to upgrade this because this is, like, one of my favorite, you know, killer animal films. And that's Long Weekend. Love this film. It looks fantastic on Blu-ray. It's just such a great fucking movie, man. Really, really good social commentary and, you know, undertones and things that are going on in this. It's such a great film to dissect. But, you know, if you're not about that, just enjoy the movie. Long Weekend. Awesome stuff. Great fucking release by Synapse Films. Fuck, I don't know why my neck is so damn itchy today. Next up here is, I had to grab these. I'm actually a big fan of both these sequels. Poltergeist 2. Still haven't checked it out. Still brand new. Got it for like dirt cheap. These things were like $10 brand new or something. I don't know why they're so cheap, but Poltergeist 2. But I actually prefer Poltergeist 3 over Part 2. I know a lot of that's blasphemy to people. I wish these had the original cover arts because I love the VHS or the original poster art for Poltergeist 3 with the tower. It just looks so cool. But I prefer Poltergeist 3. I love this one. Yeah, hopefully they look good on Blu-ray. Next up, the next few are the other Scream Factories from the month of May. And first up here is Empire of the Ants and Jaws of Satan double feature. Yeah, I actually got all these, man. I ordered all these and they actually came on time. I don't think I really got anything delayed this month, which is strange because every time I order Scream Factories, they come super delayed. But yeah, so Empire of the Ants, fucking such a fun movie, such a fun flick. Jaws of Satan, I actually did watch. I've seen this movie many times, but Jaws of Satan I checked out. It's a pretty cheesy, you know, killer snake film. Basically, it's, you know, Satan in the form of a snake. It's okay. It has its moments. It's not fantastic, but, you know, the transfer was great. So, you know, pretty cool release. And this other double feature, man, shit. Food of the Gods and Frogs. I watched Food of the Gods. It's so fucking good, man. I love Food of the Gods, man. It's just so cheesy. Huge killer rats among things. You know, there's big chickens in it. There's big wasps. But it's mostly about killer rats and stuff, which is very cool. Maybe I'll get another 7 killer rat films to make another killer rat theme week. It will be my third one. It's incredible. But I do have a couple more, actually. I haven't reviewed, so. But yeah, Food of the Gods, fantastic stuff. Frogs, I'm a big fan of that film. I need to check out the transfer on this, but Frogs is a cool film. Next up is one I have was super not impressed that Scream Factory was releasing, but I'm a Scream Factory whore and I buy all their fucking releases. And Stigmata. The thing is with this movie, man, is that it's actually not a bad movie. I just don't really understand why they would take a chance on this. Apparently didn't work out too well for them. It sold like shit, and I'm probably the only person that actually bought this release, because, you know, I'm an idiot, of course. But yeah, it's not that bad of a film. Just not worthy of an upgrade. I mean, I'm fine with the DVD that I have. Next up here is an IFC Scream Factory release, and that's Extraterrestrial. And man, I was super impressed with this film. I really enjoyed this. Done by the Vicious Brothers. So far, apparently they've had a pretty good run of films. I haven't seen Grave Encounters yet, so I can't really say, but I've heard really good things about it. But this one right here, I thought it was good, man. I love the ending. I love the old school look of the aliens. Yeah, a lot of mixed opinions on this one, but I was a fan. Yeah, check it out at your own risk, I guess. And last up for the Scream Factories is the release of Mad Max. Now, oddly enough, I picked up Mad Max, 2 and 3 last month. And the transfer on the Road Warrior is actually better than the Scream Factory one. And it was only like $6. These ones are like, you know, 15, 16, which is probably the cheapest collector's edition out there. You can get these at Walmart. You can get these anywhere, really. Mad Max is fucking everywhere. But yeah, I'm not actually the hugest fan of Mad Max, to be honest. I rewatched it. I find it doesn't really do a lot for me. I'm a bigger fan of the sequels, to be honest. So, but, you know, still a decent release. Got some special features, so. Mad Max, moving along with the Blu-rays. A couple non-horror releases, but I had to grab Lucy. Because Scarlett Johansson is my baby. I love her. this was actually a really cool premise. I really enjoyed the idea behind this, you know, using 100% of your brain and stuff. I think that's a pretty interesting premise. But I think this is... an idea that could have definite sequels, man. But yeah, Scarlett Johansson, fuck, she's awesome. Yeah, this is very out of the mix, but Breakfast Club, I love John Hughes films, whatever, call me what you want, but this is the new release, 30th anniversary, no slipcover, so I don't know. But, and we grabbed Sam Peckinpah's last film, The Osterman Weekend, which I've never seen before. Never seen this one. This Blu-ray is super cheap. You can get it for like $9. But yeah, very cool stuff. And moving along with the Blu-rays here. I grabbed a film called Wolves because I love werewolf films. Now this one right here appears, like when you first look at it, it kind of looks like a Twilight-ish kind of werewolf type deal. You know, at first I was a little concerned with it. The guy that, you know, actually plays the main character in this, I was like, well, he could kind of fit into those type of films. But it has a really intriguing story to it. I will say that the werewolves don't look the greatest in this film. There's a little bit, the transformations are CG. There's a lot of practical effects in this, though. But it was very enjoyable, man. I really enjoyed this. It was actually quite well done. Yeah, it's probably not for everybody, but it was enjoyable, man. I don't know. Something about it, I enjoyed it. Next up here is a couple 88 films releases that I grabbed, and first up is the Toxic Avenger Part 3, because I have Part 1 and 2 already from 88 films, and I was sad to learn that this is actually not cut or uncut. Now, they released Part 1 and Part 2 uncut, and Part 4, but not Part 3. Super pissy about that, so I haven't even checked this out yet. I'm really not in the mood for watching cut versions of Toxic Avenger, so... kind of disappoints me, and it's interesting that they downgraded their cases too. These aren't, you know, the fat cases. These Part 1 and 2 are like in the UK fat cases, green ones, and these are thin. That's fucking strange. Whatever. And then here's Citizen Toxie, The Toxic Avenger Part 4, which I did watch, and the transfer is fantastic on this. It looks really great. A lot of special features. Of course, it's uncut. It's got the long documentary on here, which is really cool. This is a good release. I don't know what's up with Part 3, why it's not cut, or why it's not cut, why it's uncut, why it is cut. Holy fuck, I can't talk, because I've probably been drinking too much. Next up here is a slasher video slash Olive release, and that is of Satan's Blade. Yeah, a lot of buzz about this film. Very cool to see, you know, this film get a release, because it was very obscure early 80s slasher film. I have to say, though, this movie bored the absolute living shit out of me. I was so fucking bored in this movie. Yeah, I can't recommend this movie at all. Like, I love low-budget, shitty slashers. You know me, if you watch my channel, you know I love a lot of shit. Literally. This one right here was just boring. It only runs 82 minutes, but I was just having a hard time with it, man. But I did like the music in it. The music's good. You know, the kills are pretty basic, but it's just a lot of kind of filler, it seems like to me. I don't know. I was bored as fuck. Maybe I'll rewatch it, but Satan's Blade. Not a big fan of the film. Cool release, though. Next up here from... next couple were sent to me from Anchor Bay. And that's Echoes right here. I'll have a review coming up for this one shortly. Still sealed. I haven't got a chance to watch this one yet. I don't really know what to expect from this one. So, but yeah, Echoes. I did a review for Hellmouth. This one is kind of in the vein of like a Sin City. You can check out the full length review. But I really... fucking enjoy this movie. It's probably my favorite film of the year so far, to be honest. It's up there. I loved it. Hellmouth, give it a shot. Awesome stuff. I think this is a Canadian only release right now. Might be getting an American release, but yeah, definitely check it out. Really, really good stuff. One that's been getting a lot of buzz is The Drownsman. I did a review for it. I gave it about a 5.5 out of 10. It's fucking... very, very average, man. I was really wanting a lot more from this. I think the idea is there. I think it was executed pretty poorly. I think the biggest flaw in this film is the lack of, you know, likability with the characters. You know, you want to root for these people, but you don't really care for them too much. They all seem interchangeable. Like, they're all fucking the same person. And I don't know. Check out my review. I don't know. I wasn't a big fan. I know some people really enjoyed it. Maybe they can do some more with some sequels, because I think there is a franchise here, to be honest. Next up is Let Us Pray. I did a review for this one. I thought this was really, really executed fantastically. Fantastic film. Definitely check out the review I did. Let Us Pray. Awesome stuff. This is the Canadian release, if you're wondering why the cover art's different. Next up here from Redemption is The Escapees. Finally got my hands on this. Man, I couldn't believe this, man. This was... going for like 27 or 28 bucks on Amazon, and one day it dropped down to 13, snagged it up, and pre-ordered it, and it went right back up. So I don't know what it was with that, but I got it for 13 bucks on Amazon.ca. Of course, all of her stuff is always more expensive, but The Escapees from Jean Roland, huge fan. You know, me with my Redemption line, I've collected them all, and there's 45 now. Actually, technically, there's only 44 because there's no number 13. But have them all, Escapees. Looking forward to checking that out. Next couple releases here from Arrow. I actually bought a couple Arrow video releases this month. And this one right here I've been after for a while. One of my favorite Fulci films. And that's House by the Cemetery. I got this actually for about, I think, 11 bucks shipped on Amazon.ca. It was just brand new. It was a fucking crazy deal. This one right here, I believe, is an all-region. Yeah, this is an all-region release, so, you know, you can definitely pick this up if you don't have an all-region player. But I do advise you get one. Makes life a lot easier. But yeah, great, great release. Awesome transfer. Now, this one I was kind of pissed off with, but this is another all-region release, too, actually. And that's Class of Nukem High. My case came a little busted on the top there. Kind of pisses me off. But, I mean, it still closes fine. You know, of course, the two discs, but... you know, it's still okay. The only problem is finding like a replacement case for this around here. Pretty much impossible. But you know, Class of Nukem High looks fucking fantastic on Blu-ray. Looks really good, so. And moving along here. Next up here from Black Fawn. Pre-ordered this a long time ago. Finally got my copy in. And that is Horsehead. Limited to 500 Blu-rays. Got number 168. Like the number... number does not matter, I'm hiccuping. Heard really good things about this. Gonna be doing a review for another edition of it that I have, actually. But yeah, Horsehead. And Artsploitation was kindly enough to send me over this. I didn't even say anything to them about this. They just sent me this over, and I've got Horsehead released by Artsploitation. So I actually have two copies of Horsehead on Blu-ray. Go figure. But this is kind of interesting. They use the fat cases on here, like the UK style cases. I thought that was really interesting. But this one right here is only a single disc edition. The Black Fawn is a double disc, so. But I'll have a review of this movie coming up. Next up here from Kino. Finally got my hands on this, man. Been wanting this one since it came out. And yeah, Cauldron of Blood from by, you know, featuring Boris Karloff. This is a fantastic film, man. I've seen this shit before. It's just really, really great film. Yeah, looking forward to checking out the transfer of that. Love the cover art. It's awesome. Grabbed this one today from HMV. I was bored and I was coming home. I needed to digest some Indian food that I'd eaten. I grabbed this one for about 15, probably a little overpriced, but, and that's Troll 2, the Blu-ray. Just didn't have, I have the DVD, you know, the double pack, but I love Troll 2. It's such a shitty, awesome, good movie, you know, but yeah, Troll 2. Next up here is another one that was sent to me from Arsploitation, and that's, Der Samurai. Now, I've heard really interesting things about this. I'm so stoked to check this out. I'll have a review of it coming up soon. It just looks very, very intriguing. I believe this one comes out like June 16th or something like that. So, yeah, I'll have one coming out. Review for that. And these last ones, courtesy of all the films. And, yeah, I love this. This movie's awesome. I can't wait to check out the transfer on it. And it's, of course, It, The Terror from Beyond Space. This is like a no-brainer right here. You got to pick this up. Really good stuff right here. Had to grab Coffee, of course, from Jack Hill. Absolutely love Coffee. Man, you know, Pam Grier, she's, you know, the queen of blaxploitation. Love Jack Hill and Pam Grier. And of course, the basically the follow-up in Foxy Brown. I'm not even sure which one I prefer more, to be honest, but I'll have reviews of these coming out too, actually. So, and last up for the Blu-rays is Peter Benchley's TV film featuring Craig T. Nelson and Kim Cattrall, and that's Creature. I've never seen this movie. I've always wanted to check it out. It's like the 3-hour uncut version of it, so really stoked to check out Creature. Have a review for this coming soon, you know, in the next couple weeks or whatever, so be on the lookout for that, but Creature. And yes, that is going to do it. I hope this update is not that long because I just showed off shit, man, like 120 things or something, like stupid month. But yeah, anyways, guys, if you've seen any of the film, shit, if you've seen any of these films, guys, definitely leave some comments down below. And yeah, I'd like to hear what you guys thought of some of the films, if you've seen them, and maybe your just thoughts on my shitty ass video. I don't know. If you're still with me, that's fucking amazing. And yeah, check you guys later. Peace. Next up here is Scavenger Killers, also from Dylan Bank. Pretty much having the same cast as Bleeding Hearts. This one was a lot of fucking fun. Basically kind of a Bonnie and Clyde type story. Really fun, kind of sexually motivated. And I had a lot of fun with Scavenger Killers. Really cool stuff. Hellfire, another film I did a review for, you can find on my channel. Actually, Scavenger Killers is on Body Bags. You can find the review on Body Bags for this. And, Hellfire, did a review for this one. This was fantastic. Really fucking awesome flick. Check out the review. Axe to the Grind, another film I did a review for. This one was above average. It was above average with, Debbie Rochon. You know, you can check out the full review of it, but I don't think it's her strongest film, but it was still decent. It's worth a watch. Next up here is Crazy Murder. I just did a review of this yesterday. I'm not sure if you guys have checked it out yet, but definitely give it a shot. Holy fuck, this is probably one of the sickest and most deprived films I've watched in so long, man. This was nasty, really, really fucking nasty. But cool though, man. I really enjoyed it. Not for everybody, but give it a shot though. Next up here is the Bible Belt Slasher. I will be doing a review of this one soon, once I get a little more free time, but the review will be coming out. I know the guy that directed this film, I can't remember what his name is. I know he's this blonde guy right here. Bradley Carenzo. I remember him from the VHS documentary. He was on there. He's the guy that has the VHS, basically movie store in his basement. Pretty fucking cool stuff, but yeah, so that'll be coming. And another one from Midnight here is a film called Misogynist. Now, I'm not 100% sure if I'm going to be doing a review of this one, because I don't really think it's a horror film, but, you know, if I end up really liking it or something, I'll probably do one, but Misogynist, pretty cool stuff. All right, so now into the kind of where did I pick these up from? Second Spin and some charity shop stuff. First up here is Chaos. Been wanting to see this one for fucking ever, man. Really, been wanting to see this forever. And I finally watched it last night, and it's basically Last House on the Left with a different ending. That's pretty much what it is. Pretty fucking nasty, though. Pretty nasty. Not really too sure on how I feel. I kind of liked it, but I don't know. It's not for everybody. Pretty extreme stuff. Next up here is Alien Raiders. Couldn't resist it, man. It was a couple bucks. Sounded fucking cheesy. This one I could not pass up. This is an Olive release on DVD, and it's called Shame the Devil. Yeah, I couldn't pass this one up, man. It was only about $4 or something, so I was like, whatever, $3-4. So, yeah, give it a shot. Now, this one right here I can knock off my wish list. I've had this one on a fucking list to grab for so long. This edition, Eurashot Collection, released by Image. And that is Cave of the Living Dead. This one I've been after for so long. I'm just going to move these DVDs over here because there's too much shit going on here. Yeah, this one's been on the list forever. So finally knocked that one off the list. Next up here is another Don Doler film. I got to get my hands on the first one, and that's Alien Factor 2. Some really cheesy stuff released by Retro Media, which is pretty fucking cool, man, that they release this. I got to get these stickers off here. But I love me some Don Doler, you know. Awesome stuff. Next up is a Wes Craven film. I think Wes Craven presents this. Yeah, he presents this film. They actually sent me the wrong edition, though, because I ordered the unrated version. This is the PG-13 version and of They. I have seen this movie. I watched it when it came out, and I can't remember it for the life of me. So I wanted to check it out again. I can't remember if I liked it or not, so I'll give it a shot again once I get the right edition. This one right here, I only grabbed because I have no idea why I grabbed this movie. You know, when I first opened up my box, I was like, did I even order this? And I did. So, and that is Hellbenders. I think I must have read the synopsis on this one. I think it's a, it's like an exorcist type, demon type film. I don't know. So, I don't know. Give that one a shot. Now, this one I've actually had on a list to grab for a long time, too. It's released by Retro Media also. 25th anniversary edition of Alien Dead. of course I would grab some bullshit like this. Alien Dead, I don't know. This one actually looks pretty damn cool. Might do a review of it. I had to grab this because it just... I love Tiffany Amber Thiessen, man. I think she's fucking so hot, man. Whatever. And that is Shriek If You Know What I Did Last Friday the 13th. I've actually never seen this spoof film before. It's probably fucking terrible. Man, this shit has Coolio in it. It's got Coolio. Yeah. That's pretty awesome, but cool stuff. Finally got my hands on this shit right here. I've been after this one for a long time, and that's Stuart Gordon's Deathbed. It also comes with Castle Freak. I have Castle Freak on DVD and I believe Blu-ray too, so not a big deal now. But I grabbed it for Deathbed, so very, very cool stuff. And these ones right here were like pawn shop pickups. They're only a couple bucks. Yeah, I only grabbed them because they were just sitting there. And whatever. First up is The Mailman. This movie right here was absolutely atrocious. I did watch this. It was fucking terrible. I absolutely hated this movie, so don't check it out. Finally grabbed a copy of this. I never owned this. The Descent 2. I haven't really heard a lot of people talk about this one, to be honest. Strangely and oddly enough, considering the first one a lot of people consider to be one of the best horror films of the 2000s, but... I don't know, I've heard this one isn't as good, but I am curious to check it out, so The Descent 2. I grabbed this one right here, Intermedio, because Edward Furlong was in. I actually like Edward Furlong, I think he's kind of cool, but it's the only reason why I grabbed it. It was $2, so why not? Give it a shot. Next up here is another cheesy-ass pickup called The Chair. I'm just grabbing shit for the sake of grabbing shit, apparently, man. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with my life anymore. Candy Stripers, Candy Strippers, I mean, not Candy Stripers, not the porno, Candy Strippers, yeah, this one looks awful. The Graveyard, another one that looks really, really fucking bad. I don't know what is with all these Lionsgate films, but they seem to produce a lot of bullshit. I did not pay $9.99 for this, but this is Bernie Knight, and I've actually heard decent things about this, so willing to give this one a shot right here. Next up here is Glass Trap. Now, I had to grab this one because it's a fucking PG-13 insect, killer insect film directed by Fred Olen Ray. Starring C. Thomas Howell. I mean, this was like a no-brainer. Of course I was going to grab that bullshit. Next up here is House of Fallen. Yeah, I don't know. Another film with C. Thomas Howell. What the fuck? Grab Devil. Never seen this one before. $2, why not? I was like, eh, fuck, whatever. And I grabbed this one because I'm a completist and I don't even like the first two films. I Always Know What You Did Last Summer. I'm not a big fan of I Know What You Did Last Summer and the second one. I really do not like those films at all. I think they suck. But yeah, here's the third one. I've actually never seen it. The Ferryman. So I got The Mailman, The Ferryman, The Chair, The Graveyard. Jesus Christ, these are all terrible. And we got a film I grabbed because it is starring Marissa Tomei and I find that she's so fucking beautiful. I absolutely love her. And that is Danica. And I think it's like a more of like a psychological thriller with horror elements and stuff. But, you know, you can't pass up anything with Marissa Tomei that's in that realm of almost horror, I guess. But yeah, that's the way I roll. So, yeah. Fucking beer time, man. Yeah. My Asian part of my update. Aw, yeah. Well, let's get into the Asian portion of the update. Gia. I grabbed a fucking shit ton of Asian films. Now I'm pissed off because I ordered the Ebola Syndrome and it didn't come in for this update. And it would have made a perfect entry into this huge stack of Asian films. I'm on this Asian kick right now. I should probably start watching some of these films, but I'm busy with all these fucking reviews, but yeah, let's get into this. First up, I'm going to show a Blu-ray out of order because it is kind of fits into the Asian portion of the update here. And that is Gunwoman, released by Scream Factory. This movie right here, in my opinion, is a modern day classic. 10 out of 10. Yeah, what's up everybody? Welcome to another DVD / Blu-ray update. This is going to be my haul for May of 2015, everything I picked up in May. And I will forewarn you, I have no idea how long this video is going to last, but it's going to be a long one. I have a lot of stuff. I picked up a lot of stuff. I had some stuff sent to me from friends. I'm just going to rotate this table here so it's a little easier for me. Some companies too, which was kind of cool too, but most of the stuff I did buy myself. Yeah, fucking, you know, companies like Scream Factory this month just burnt a goddamn hole in my pocket as usual. But first off, Chars to everybody out there. Grab a beer, sit back, and enjoy the motherfucking update. Yeah. Alrighty, so first off here, I want to show something I picked up. I posted a picture on Instagram of this right after I grabbed it. We had a fan con here in the city I live in, and Tia Carrera was going to be there. And oddly enough, This was actually kind of strange. So I brought this DVD up to get signed, and she looked at it and she goes, "Holy shit." She's like, "That movie has a DVD release?" She didn't even know this had a DVD release. And then she continued to tell me that I was the first person that she'd ever signed something like this, obviously, because she didn't even know it had a DVD release, which I feel kind of honored that I'm like the only person, because I'm pretty sure nobody else in the city has this release. And that is Zombie Nightmare. I didn't buy this recently, of course, but I got it signed by Tia Carrera. This was her first feature film, of course, before, you know, she made it huge with Wayne's World and stuff. But yeah, you know, everybody in line had Wayne's World stuff, and I was like, oh, come on. But yeah, if you can see that, it says Moods, XOXO. I have to say, man, Tia Carrera was very, very nice, and she's still beautiful as hell. Looks awesome. And she was really nice to talk to, man. She gave me the time, and we talked about the film, and she's like, "It's such a shitty movie, I can't believe you like it." I laughed so hard when she said that. She's like, "That movie's terrible." But I'm like, you know what? Yeah, it is. It's a bad movie, but it's fun. And she's like, "Yeah, you're right." But cool stuff right there. I was happy to get that signed up. But okay, moving along into the DVDs and all the other... You can kind of see the stack in the corner there. First up here from Mondo Macabro. Yeah, I picked up about 4 releases this month, and they all came in red cases. I'm very proud about that. I've had bad luck with Mondo releases. Being sealed in black cases, strange. First up here is Gravida. Gravidia? So it's an Alain Rollet-Gelais film. I love his films, man. Redemption, the Kino Line, released a bunch of films by him that I was very impressed with. So I've been dying to check this one out, but I love Mondo Macabro. Definitely wanted to grab that one. Next up here is a Italian film called The Snake God. My boy Zach was, you know, he was, I think we were Skyping one night. We were drinking and shit, and I was drinking, he was smoking, and he started laughing. He's like, we started talking about The Snake God, and I just ordered it, and I'm like, "Yeah, I just ordered it," and he starts laughing. He's like, "Fuck Moons, you got a problem." But yeah, I've heard good things, so thank you, Zach, for recommending me that one. And seriously, I'm dropping fucking DVDs. This one right here was actually the other one that I ordered when I was talking to Zach on Skype one night, and this is Girl Slays of Morgana Le Fay, right there. So yeah, looking forward to checking this one out. This one looks really fucking cool. Another French film from the early 70s, 1971. Love me some Mondo Macabros. Like I said, man, stoked they're all in red cases for once. Fucking awesome. All still sealed. Need to check them out. Artsploitation was kindly enough to send me over this release, which hasn't been released yet. But be on the lookout for review, because I'm going to be reviewing this, and I've heard really good things about it so far, which is, has me ecstatic about it. And that is The House with 100 Eyes. This looks really, really fucking awesome. It's basically, from what I've read on the back and what I've heard, it's kind of about like snuff filmmaking and stuff, so kind of found footage style, but I heard it's really good. Looking forward to checking that one out right there. Anchor Bay was kindly enough to send over this one to me, and I did a review, and I wasn't too sure on this one, because some of these films could be kind of generic, and this one turned out to be fucking fantastic, and it's Avenged. Awesome, awesome revenge flick. It's basically a rape revenge flick with a twist, kind of. But I really like the story, man. I like the characters. She's a deaf mute, tries to save like a Native American from being these rednecks. They're hunting these guys down and basically killing them. Of course, it doesn't go so well. They capture her, end up raping her, and doing some nasty things. She ends up dying, and local shaman kind of resurrects her, and unfortunately also brings upon an Apache warrior's soul or something like that into her body, and then they go on a killing rampage. It's actually... You know, as lame as that kind of sounds, it's really fucking good. It was gory, it was fun, it was well executed. I had a lot of fun with this. Check out Avenged. I did a full review for this, so I guess I didn't really need to explain the whole fucking thing again, because I'm retarded. Next up here from Anchor Bay. This one right here, I was going to do a review for. I'm going to not do one because it's going to be really, really bad. And that is The Vatican Exorcisms. Basically, this is kind of... like a found footage film, not really a found footage, it's like a, you know, it's supposed to be a documentary where this American, which is played by this Italian guy, which is so strange, actually, the director of the film, Joe Morano, actually stars in this. And he basically goes to the to Italy to investigate the Vatican and all these conspiracy theories and all these things that have apparently happened there and stuff with all these exorcisms and these wild, crazy orgies and all these other things. It has some really good ideas in the beginning, but it's kind of like false advertising a little bit. They present you with all these great ideas in the beginning of the film, and it's basically just him going around witnessing and filming these exorcisms. Something happens to him, and, you know, and it turns out to be a very cliched film. Not good. This was actually really fucking horrible, so don't check it out. Sorry. Next up here, I had to pick this up. Of course, in fucking Canada, I can't find the Blu-ray of this because I swear to God, we did not get any Blu-rays in our fucking Best Buys. I know they were Best Buy exclusives, so we should have. So I grabbed the DVD and it was only like $9, and that is Zombievers. Shit, man. I had a lot of fucking fun with this. Really stupid, this kind of film, man. It's very reminiscent of the 80s. It reminded me of Return of the Living Dead Part 2, where the canister falls out of the truck and then pollutes some waters. And of course, these beavers turn into zombies. And when they fucking bite humans, they actually turn kind of beaverish too. Tons of beaver jokes, super fucking funny. Practical effects, though, that was really what sold it for me. A couple of the characters were kind of annoying, but, you know, I had a lot of fun with this. I'd actually watch this again with some beers. Pretty good stuff. Next up from Severin here. Finally fucking pulled the trigger on this. This movie never seems to go down in price. Ever. And it is another rape revenge film. You know, me with my rape revenge films, I think I have a problem because I watch too many of them. And that's Last House on the Beach. Of course, it's called Last House something, right? This one is basically about these bank robbers. They're obviously fleeing the scene of the crime. They go out to the country, and where she plays a nun, and she's got some students out there, and they're doing some training and stuff like that. They're studying for exams, and of course, some shit goes down once they, you know, fucking... Poltergeist 2, still haven't checked it out, still brand new. Got it for, like, dirt cheap. These things were, like, $10 brand new or something. I don't know why they're so cheap, but Poltergeist 2, but I actually prefer Poltergeist 3 over Part 2. I know a lot of that's blasphemy to people. I wish these had the original cover arts, because I love the VHS or the original poster art for Poltergeist 3 with the tower. It just looks so cool. But I prefer Poltergeist 3. I love this one. Yeah, hopefully they look good on Blu-ray. Next up, the next few are the other Scream Factories from the month of May. And, first up here is Empire of the Ants and Jaws of Satan double feature. Yeah, I actually got all these, man. I ordered all these and they actually came on time. I don't think I really got anything delayed this month, which is strange because every time I order Scream Factories, they come super delayed. But yeah, so Empire of the Ants, fucking such a fun movie, such a fun flick. Jaws of Satan, I actually did watch. I've seen this movie many times, but Jaws of Satan I checked out. It's a pretty cheesy, you know, killer snake film. Basically, it's, you know, Satan in the form of a snake. It's okay. It has its moments. It's not fantastic, but, you know, the transfer was great. So, you know, pretty cool release. And this other double feature, man, shit. Food of the Gods and Frogs. I watched Food of the Gods. It's so fucking good, man. I love Food of the Gods, man. It's just so cheesy. Huge killer rats among things. You know, there's big chickens in it. There's big wasps. But it's mostly about killer rats and stuff, which is very cool. Maybe I'll get another 7 killer rat films to make another killer rat theme week. It'll be my third one. It's incredible. But I do have a couple more, actually, I haven't reviewed, so. But yeah, Food of the Gods, fantastic stuff. Frogs, I'm a big fan of that film. I need to check out the transfer on this, but Frogs is a cool film. Next up is one I have was super not impressed that Scream Factory was releasing, but I'm a Scream Factory whore, and I buy all their fucking releases. And Stigmata. The thing is with this movie, man, is that it's actually not a bad movie. I just don't really understand why they would take a chance on this. Apparently it didn't work out too well for them. It sold like shit, and I'm probably the only person that actually bought this release, because, you know, I'm an idiot, of course. But yeah, it's not that bad of a film. Just not worthy of an upgrade. I mean, I'm fine with the DVD that I have. Next up here is an IFC Scream Factory release, and that's Extraterrestrial. And man, I was super impressed with this film. I really enjoyed this. Done by the Vicious Brothers. So far, apparently they've had a pretty good run of films. I haven't seen Grave Encounters yet, so I can't really say, but I've heard really good things about it. But this one right here, I thought it was good, man. I love the ending. I love the old school look of the aliens. Yeah, a lot of mixed opinions on this one, but I was a fan. Yeah, check it out at your own risk, I guess. And last up for the Scream Factories is the release of Mad Max. Now, oddly enough, I picked up Mad Max, 2 and 3 last month. And the transfer on the Road Warrior is actually better than the Scream Factory one. And it was only like $6. These ones are like, you know, 15, 16, which is probably the cheapest collector's edition out there. You can get these at Walmart. You can get these anywhere, really. Mad Max is fucking everywhere. But yeah, I'm not actually the hugest fan of Mad Max, to be honest. I rewatched it. I find it doesn't really do a lot for me. I'm a bigger fan of the sequels, to be honest. So, but, you know, still a decent release. Got some special features, so. Mad Max, moving along with the Blu-rays. A couple non-horror releases, but I had to grab Lucy. Because Scarlett Johansson is my baby. I love her. this was actually a really cool premise. I really enjoyed the idea behind this, you know, using 100% of your brain and stuff. I think that's a pretty interesting premise. But I think this is, an idea that could have definite sequels, man. But yeah, Scarlett Johansson, fuck, she's awesome. Yeah, this is very out of the mix, but Breakfast Club, I love John Hughes films, whatever, call me what you want, but this is the new release, 30th anniversary, no slipcover, so, I don't know, but, and we grabbed Sam Peckinpah's last film, The Osterman Weekend, which I've never seen before, never seen this one. This Blu-ray is super cheap, you can get it for like $9, but yeah, very cool stuff. And moving along with the Blu-rays here. I grabbed a film called Wolves because I love werewolf films. Now this one right here appears, like when you first look at it, it kind of looks like a Twilight-ish kind of werewolf type deal. You know, at first I was a little concerned with it. The guy that, you know, actually plays the main character in this, I was like, well, he could kind of fit into those type of films. But it has a really intriguing story to it. I will say that the werewolves don't look the greatest in this film. There's a little bit, the transformations are CG. There's a lot of practical effects in this though, but it was very enjoyable, man. I really enjoyed this. It was actually quite well done. Yeah, it's probably not for everybody, but it was enjoyable, man. I don't know, something about it, I enjoyed it. Next up here is a couple 88 films releases that I grabbed. And first up is the Toxic Avenger part 3. I have part 1 and 2 already from 88 films. And I was sad to learn that this is actually not cut or uncut. Now, they released part 1 and part 2 uncut and part 4, but not part 3. Super pissy about that. So I haven't even checked this out yet. I'm really not in the mood for watching cut versions of Toxic Avengers. So kind of disappoints me. And it's interesting that they downgraded their cases too. These aren't, you know, the fat cases. These part 1 and 2 are like in the UK fat cases, green ones. And these are thin. That's fucking strange. Whatever. And then here's Citizen Toxie, The Toxic Avenger Part 4, which I did watch, and the transfer is fantastic on this. It looks really great. A lot of special features. Of course, it's uncut. It's got the, you know, the long documentary on here, which is really cool. This is a good release. I don't know what's up with Part 3, why it's not cut, or why it's not cut, why it's uncut, why it is cut. Holy fuck, I can't talk, because I'm probably even drinking too much. Next up here is a slasher video slash Olive release, and that is of Satan's Blade. Yeah, a lot of buzz about this film. Very cool to see, you know, this film get a release, because it was very obscure early 80s slasher film. I have to say, though, this movie bored the absolute living shit out of me. I was so fucking bored in this movie. Yeah, I can't recommend this movie at all. Like, I love low-budget, shitty slashers. You know me, if you watch my channel, you know I love a lot of shit. Literally. This one right here was just boring. It only runs 82 minutes, but I was just having a hard time with it, man. But I did like the music in it. The music's good. You know, the kills are pretty basic, but it's just a lot of kind of filler, it seems like to me. I don't know. I was bored as fuck. Maybe I'll rewatch it, but Satan's Blade, not a big fan of the film. Cool release, though. Next up here from, next couple were sent to me from Anchor Bay, and that's Echoes right here. I'll have a review coming up for this one shortly. Still sealed. I haven't got a chance to watch this one yet. I don't really know what to expect from this one, so, but yeah, Echoes. Did a review for Hellmouth. This one is kind of in the vein of like a Sin City. You can check out the full length review, but I really fucking enjoy this movie. It's probably my favorite film of the year so far, to be honest. It's up there. I loved it. Hellmouth, give it a shot. Awesome stuff. I think this is a Canadian-only release right now. Might be getting an American release, but yeah, definitely check it out. Really, really good stuff. One that's been getting a lot of buzz is The Drownsman. I did a review for it. I gave it about a 5.5 out of 10. It's fucking very, very average, man. I was really wanting a lot more from this. I think the idea is there. I think it was executed pretty poorly. But I think the biggest flaw in this film is the lack of, you know, likability with the characters. You know, you want to root for these people, but you don't really care for them too much. They all seem interchangeable. Like, they're all fucking the same person, and I don't know. Check out my review. I don't know. I wasn't a big fan. I know some people really enjoyed it. Maybe they can do some more with some sequels, because I think there is a franchise here, to be honest. Next up is Let Us Pray. I did a review for this one. I thought this was really, really executed fantastically. Fantastic film. Definitely for me, man. I love this movie so much. It was just fucking fantastic. Great revenge film. Love the story. Love the action. I love the way it was shot. Just an amazing, amazing film. Highly, highly recommend Gunwoman if you've never seen this. Of course, it does come with reversible art. So you'll probably see this if you're hunting for it in stores or whatever. You'll see that cover art if you can see that. But yeah, I highly recommend Gunwoman. Just got to check it out. It's really fucking amazing. Good stuff right there. Gunwoman. Next up is a Shaw Brothers film that's been recommended to me by a bunch of people, actually. And I really dig these films, man. And that's The Boxer's Omen. The Boxer's Omen. So, looking forward to checking that shit out right there. Released by Image. Yeah. Sounds really fucking cool. Next up here from Synapse Films. One of my favorite companies out. If not my favorite company. And that is Battle Girl, The Living Dead in Tokyo Bay. Got this one for about $3 or $4 or something. I don't know. Really good shape. Just super stoked to check it out, man. Yeah. Another Snaps release. I've been after forever this one too, man. And that's Madame O. Another Snaps release. I actually got a bunch more Snaps coming. Yeah, courtesy of my boy Jeremy. But yeah, looking forward to checking that one out right there. Here's the other Mondo Macabro title that I was talking about earlier. And that's Sins of Sister Lucia. This is a Japanese flick. Of course, it came in the red case, which I'm super stoked about. So, like I said, 4 for $4 this month. But yeah, awesome stuff. Love my nunsploitation. I'm going to have a nunsploitation theme week probably soon. Next up is one called Black Kiss. This is released by Tokyo Shock. Heard really good things about this one. And when I opened up this one, it was very interesting. I was like, okay, there's the disc. That's pretty cool. But look on the side there. It's got one of those little mini half-discs. I can't remember what these things are fucking called. I've never seen one of these in a Tokyo Shock or any Media Blasters releases before. But it is a DVD. And it's like a trailer compilation for like Flesh of the Beast and a few other films and stuff. So that's an interesting touch that they had in here. But never seen one like that. You know, it's the first one. And I own a lot of these. You know, it's very strange it was in this one. But Black Kiss. Next up is one I can't really pronounce too well, and that's Mariner. It's a doll horror movie. It tells you right on the cover, it's a doll horror movie. I love that. But yeah, this one just looked creepy as shit. Released by Elite. Of course, I grabbed this one used too. I got it for a couple bucks, and it doesn't even look like the disc has ever played. It's really strange. But yeah, that one looks creepy as fuck. Next up here is a, what's his name again? Cyan Sono. Strange Circus. Yeah, this guy is a really, really good director, man. He seems to be on point with all his films, but heard nothing but good things about this one, so Strange Circus. Next up, the next bunch of films are Tartan Asian Extreme films. First up here is Sorum. Actually still sealed. I bought this one used, as you can see, but it's still factory sealed, so that was really cool. I got this one for about $3-4, I think. Not even, maybe $3. It might even been $2, I don't know, but yeah, it's pretty cool. Got this one brand new, actually, and that's Marbido. You know, of course, with these, I like these slipcovers. But yeah, grab that one. Heard really good things about this one. Been recommended to me, actually, by a bunch of people. You need to check that one out. Next up here is The Red Shoes. Another one that I've heard pretty damn good things about. I can't remember if I've heard anything good about this one or not. But, you know, it's Asian. It was part of the Asian, Tartan Asian Extreme line. So I was like, whatever. Here's Phone. You can find this one for super cheap. You can find most of these for really cheap, actually. Next up is Memento Mori. I don't know. And they got Marbido. I don't know. These ones have similar titles, but I believe this is the second or third film in this trilogy. I can't remember how this works. But yeah, there's this one. I heard good things about it. And then we got Wishing Stairs. This one looks really damn fucking cool, too. And we got Whispering Corridors, which is the film that started the Asian horror boom. The first in the Whispering Corridors trilogy. And I believe these are the three in the trilogy. I believe so. I believe there's actually like five films connected to this also. And I think I might even have the other ones too. I'm just not 100% sure. I'll have to kind of look that up. Somebody correct me down in the comments, because I never know what I'm talking about ever. No, this is all new. I haven't seen the films yet, so I haven't done much research. But I'm positive this is a trilogy, and apparently there's like a couple other ones. So, but yeah, that's really cool. Next up is a film that I've tried to get a couple times. They kept sending me the wrong copies, and that's Silk. Another Tartan Asian Extreme film. I don't know anything about that one. I've never heard anyone talk about it. This one has been recommended to me by lots of people, actually. My man Tom Horsball has recommended me. So many people have recommended me this film. And I finally got around to grabbing it. I got this for super cheap. I only paid about $3-4 for it or something. And that's Mobius. I think that's how you pronounce it, Mobius. Yeah, this one looks really crazy. I've heard really good things, so super stoked about that. Here's another one that's been recommended to me over and over and over again, and I've seen on lots of people's lists, and that's Infection. Yeah, really cool stuff right there. Looking forward to checking that out. Like I said, I haven't even checked out one of these fucking movies yet. Oh, except for Gunwoman. Next up here from Unearthed Films is Red Room. Still sealed. Grabbed this off Amazon for, it was actually kind of expensive. It was like $12 or $13. I was like, ugh, I don't know. But, you know, up here, that's a good deal for Unearthed Films. They usually go for $20, $22. So grab that one. And of course, I grabbed the sequel, Red Room 2. Same price. Still, these are still sealed. I just haven't. Actually, this one is not sealed for whatever. Oh, yeah, that's right. The plastic was already coming off in the package. So, yeah, but it's still brand new. And last up for the Asian stuff, which I grabbed, shit man, close to 20 fucking Asian films, and that's Nazila, the Rat Monster. Shit, I've been after this for a long time. My boy, You and Your Horror Movies, Matt from You and Your Horror Movies, actually reminded me about this. He had this on a Top 10 Tuesday list, and I was like, oh fuck, I had this on the list to grab, so I ordered it, I paused the video, ordered it up. Thank you, Matt, for checking, or for, you know, recommending to me without even knowing. But yeah, I've heard really good things about this, so. But yeah, that is, that's the fucking Asian score for the month, minus the Ebola syndrome that didn't come, and actually, now when I think about it, I think there's three films that didn't show up out of my Asian order. So yeah, that was actually not a bad haul right there for, you know, Asian horror films. My Asian film, horror film collection is really getting huge. Yeah, fucking beer time, man, and we're going to get right into these Blu-rays, and I've got probably 30, so stay tuned for that. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, it's going to be fucking Blu-ray time up in this motherfucker. But first, we need another beer because, you know, this update has been going way too damn long. And it's so funny, I'm drinking this Superstore PC Pilsner. I think you can get about 800 or 900 beers for about $20. It's a pretty good deal, man. You gotta, you know, being fucking cheap, I spent all my money on movies, so I can't afford real beer, apparently. No, I just actually don't mind it. It's not bad. Blu-ray time. First up here is one from Synapse Films. And yeah, I had to upgrade this. I mean, Synapse is... they do a pretty good job of, like, not, you know, putting out stuff on Blu-ray that they've, you know, put out on DVD before. But I had to upgrade this because this is, like, one of my favorite, you know, killer animal films. And that's Long Weekend. Love this film. It looks fantastic on Blu-ray. It's just such a great fucking movie, man. Really, really good social commentary and, you know, undertones and things that are going on in this. It's such a great film to dissect. But, you know, if you're not about that, just... just enjoy the movie. Long Weekend, awesome stuff. Great fucking release by Synapse Films. Fuck, I don't know why my neck is so damn itchy today. Next up here is, I had to grab these. I'm actually a big fan of both these sequels. Pulled basically home invade this house. You know, it's not bad. It's not bad. It was okay. I really like this actress here. What's her name? Stefana, or no, that's not her name. Shit, she's the girl that plays in Flava the Heretic. She's in that one too. She's pretty good looking, actually, but it was okay. It was okay. I had fun with it. Next up here is Livid. Now, here's a copy. If you guys watched my update from last time, I picked up a copy of Livid, and of course, it was the French edition that didn't even have English subtitles. I was so pissed. So I had to reorder this, and yeah. So, this one has English subtitles, so I'm stoked to check it out. Just haven't gotten around to it. Heard nothing but good things. Full Moon, right here. Full Moon's been pretty hit and miss with me lately. This was super cheap. I couldn't pass it up. Especially for the name alone, and that's PMS Cop. I thought this movie started out really good, and then just kind of declined big time after the fact. I don't know, man. There was a lot of story, a lot of things going on and stuff, but I think that they kind of fell away from where it was should have went. I don't know, man. Full Moon is just not on point these days, man, with their films, but this one had a lot of promise, though, but it was okay. You know, definitely, I don't fully recommend it, but I do kind of recommend it at the same time. Just give it a watch. You might like it. Next up is one I actually picked up today. In my running arounds and stuff like that. This is a film by Ryan Gosling. You know, that sexy Ryan Gosling. I'm actually a really big fan of Drive and God Only Forgives. So this is his directorial debut, and I was really curious to check it out because I heard it's kind of visually like those films, and, you know, it kind of sounds like those films, the soundtrack and stuff, and that just had me intrigued because I really, really enjoy both those movies. And that is Lost River. Now, unfortunately, in Canada, we don't have a Blu-ray release of this. We have to import this. So I was like, kind of waiting it out. I was going to import it from the US, but I was like, fuck it. I'll just grab the DVD. It was super cheap. It was like $10. So I'll grab it and check it out. And if I love it enough, then maybe I'll wait for the Blu-ray or whatever. Because this is one of those films that you kind of want to have on Blu-ray because it's very visual. But apparently, so Lost River, not a horror film, I don't think. I heard it's really weird and kind of trippy. So whatever. Next up is a film here that I've wanted to check out for a while. I heard it's really fucking good, and that's Cold in July. I also grabbed this one today. Cold in July. Heard good things. Can't wait to check it out. Here's a film right here that I really wish I had. I probably still should do a review on it. I absolutely love this movie. Fantastic from, who released this? I'm not even sure. Monster Pictures actually released this out of the UK, and that's Chocolate Strawberry Vanilla. Very, very fucking cool film. Thought it was fantastic about this guy. He's obviously, you know, owns his own ice cream truck, and he's kind of a lonely guy and doesn't really have much friends, and he's very awkward and strange, and he's kind of, the odd thing about him is that he's obsessed with this local kind of TV crime show, and especially this one girl that's on the show. And anyways, one day he doesn't find out where they're filming in Australia, but she kind of, he's just parked where they're, you know, where they're filming one day. Anyway, she comes up to the ice cream truck, grabs some ice cream, and he just becomes obsessed with her. Very, very cool fucking film. Definitely give it a shot. I loved it. It was just fantastic. Kind of psychological, very interesting character study about this guy. And yeah, it was just very enjoyable. Loved it. These next two were actually sent to me from my homie Turi, from our podcast page, the 22 Shots of Moods and Horror podcast page on Facebook. He just asked me one day, he's like, do you have these titles? And I said, no. And they just showed up at my door one day. So that's pretty damn cool. And this one is Across the River. And I did watch this. I thought this movie was very, very atmospheric and very intriguing. It's very melodic and kind of ominous. I really enjoyed this. I know a lot of people have mixed opinions on this, but I thought it was actually really creepy and trippy. I don't know, man. I thought it was really cool. You know, just, I don't want to get in the whole story about it, but very cool film. Just not a lot of dialogue because it's basically just one guy in the film. It's really trippy. And then the other one that he sent me here is Treehouse. Now, I heard a lot of people say the same thing, that they didn't enjoy the ending to this film. Now, I can understand completely why people didn't understand, or not understand, but didn't like the ending in this one. For me, I had no problem with it. I really enjoyed this film. I understand that it seems like it's kind of a cop-out and whatnot, whatever. But I had a lot of fun with this. I actually thought it was pretty damn good. So, you know, not fantastic. It totally sets it up for one thing and then it delivers another thing, which I understand, but I enjoyed Treehouse, man. I thought it was actually pretty well done. Next up here is another UK release. I picked up a lot of films from the UK this month. For some odd reason, we don't have a Region 1 release of this. I don't think we do. And that is the film from 1968 called Twisted Nerve. Now, if you've seen Kill Bill before, this is where that fucking theme whistle comes from, is Twisted Nerve. Yeah, that shit comes from this film right here, from 1968. We just recently did a top 10 films from 1968 episode on 22 Shots of Moods and Horror, and this one just really kind of blew my socks off. I really love this one. Don't want to get into it. Definitely check out the podcast. We go into it a lot more. Me and JP both had this on our top 10 list. Awesome fucking movie, man. Definitely give it a shot. Twisted Nerve. Next up is the latest Dustin Mills film, called Apple Cards. This one right here is basically kind of a throwback to the silent era, and a lot of different things that are going on in this one. I'm not gonna lie, I think this is the first Dustin Mills film I didn't really care for. I understood completely what he was trying to do. It's very experimental, but I just found a lot of the scenes to drag quite a bit in this one. I don't know. It just really didn't do a lot for me, to be honest. And it only runs about an hour long, and it felt way longer to me. I don't know. It just wasn't my favorite thing in the world. It's okay. Some people I know really enjoyed it, but it's definitely not for everybody. Next up is a 6-movie pack called Serial Psychos. Now, I grabbed this specifically because I wanted it for Blood Massacre, the Don Doler film from 1987 or something like that. I don't know what year it is. 1987. It's the only way you can get the film for some weird reason. And I love Don Doler, man. Of course, Night Beast and shit like that. Really good stuff. Awesome flick, man. It's the only one I've checked out on here so far. It also comes with 13 hip-hop locos. Hip-hop locos. Las Vegas Bloodbath, I Hate You, and Slasher. So, who knows? I'm sure the rest of the films are shitty, but whatever. Serial Psychos, 6-pack. And it actually comes on 2 discs, 3 films. And this thing was only about, I think I paid $8 for this or something. I don't know. It's probably worth it. Next up here is a Paul Naschy film that I heard isn't that great, but, you know, I had to pick it up. It dropped down to like $10 on Amazon there for a little bit, and that is the Unliving. So, yeah, I'll give it a shot. It's still sealed, so whatever. Next up is the first Blue Underground DVD I've bought in a long time, because I'm really only missing like a couple out of the entire Blue Underground DVD catalog. I had never upgraded a lot of the Blu-rays, but this is one I was missing, and I've been kind of digging these Emmanuel films, and that's Emmanuel in America. So pretty stoked about grabbing this one right here. This is the unrated version, so pretty damn cool, completely uncut. Looking forward to checking this out. Still haven't checked it out, so yeah. Emmanuel in America. These next films right here were sent to me from Midnight Releasing for review. I've always been a big fan of Midnight. I know a lot of people have their issues with Midnight Releasing and Brain Damage films because, you know, the films can be kind of hit and miss, but, you know, to be honest, they're really picking up their game as, you know, these new days, or, you know, as of now, they've been picking up some new ones. Some new good films, so. Anyways, first up here is Bleeding Hearts. I recently reviewed this one, so I'm not going to get too much into it, but I thought this was actually a pretty solid film by Dylan Bank. Really cool cast in it. Pretty interesting premise. Full review on my channel. Go check it out.